.NET Conf Focus on Modernization, we'll be doing a full recap of vibe coding .NET upgrades. Fantastic stuff. Azure MCP server has just been released. We'll be vibe coding some Azure infrastructure queries. Why not? And we'll be answering the question, should you learn .NET MAUI? Let's go. It's Ted's Tech Show. First up, I've watched 5 hours. Here is the 1 minute recap.
We looked at the types of folks that make it a little bit more bite-sized for folks that want to join. These folks, you've cool things to help folks with .NET. We've got folks from these folks don't just build
a lot of folks.
Some folks
like a lot of folks sort of give folks an idea.
Folks from folks ask. Some folks were asking questions. Some folks
I want folks
for folks. A lot of folks contribute. A lot of folks are worried.
Yay, folks! I gotcha. Folks know bicep. A lot of folks, your folks like, because folks, cloud apps are not perfect. Folks know. Your folks may remember any questions that your folks may have.
There were some folks talking.
So, folks, on the query, folks.
For folks who are running apps.
Folks.
An important lesson for folks. So folks can.
I think of folks on folks. If
we've got folks to make it easier for folks prove how folks can, that folks struggle, folks don't appreciate. There are a number of folks migrate folks from VB6 to folks in YouTube chat recommend folks use that folks need to experience. I love helping folks with these. I've got a book available for folks, 10% off for folks.
Who genuinely speaks like this? Anyway, .NET Conf folks on modernization, they actually got GitHub Copilot to do something useful. So the .NET upgrade advisor has been around for donkey's years. If you actually load an old project, it puts you through the upgrade advisor automatically. But this is actually okay. They're going to enhance it with GitHub Copilot, and essentially it will spit out one of those research things that gives you step-by-step manual instructions this time. See, this is really good, right? Look, we've got like instructions, okay? So my worry is, where is it getting this training data from? Because to upgrade a .NET framework app from, say, 4.5 all the way up to .NET 9 requires a decade of .NET architectural knowledge. It's not just about getting it to work. It's about getting it to work correctly. So have they done some special reinforcement learning on this specific GitHub Copilot .NET upgrade agent? Or have they just written a load of system prompts? Or is this actual engineering? I'd love to know. They weren't too clear on that. But it looks pretty good. Maybe we'll get more projects updated. So well done, guys. You're making the most of it. Who's
It's Tim Corey.
Did he get that right? Please leave a like if you did, because I'm trying to keep count, and we'll see who is the most recognizable silhouette of an MVP. Anyway, next up is Azure MCP. This is actually like a bit of a shadow drop this week. I'm pretty impressed. So what this is an MCP server for Microsoft Azure. It uses the authentication from the Azure CLI. So if you're already logged in, it just works. And it allows things like GitHub Copilot in agent mode or Claude or any of these MCP clients to call the tools to query your Azure resources. It's read-only at the moment, which is pretty good because it's dangerous, right? Imagine somebody says, spin me up a VM, please, Copilot, and Copilot decides to spin up the largest VM and the guy gets bill and his company goes bankrupt. And that would be not good. This has the best disclaimer I've ever seen on a project. It says, security notes. MCP is a phenomenon. It's very novel and cutting edge. As with all new technology standards, consider doing a security review to ensure any systems that integrate with MCP servers follow all regulations and standards your system is expected to adhere to. That's wild, right? It's like, they know this is spicy. Anyway, let's take a look. I'm actually going to run it. So here is the Azure MCP extension in Copilot, in agent mode, in VS Code. You can see it's been added with this JSON on this on the left. And you can see that all the tools are available like this. All the read-only tools, of course. They don't want you breaking anything just yet. What you'll also see here is that I have three resource groups in my Azure subscription, all in Japan East, which is obviously where you should put your Azure resources. Sadly, they're empty, but because I don't actually want to spend any money at the moment. So we'll try this out. Let's see what Copilot can do. And we'll actually use the microphone. Tell me a fun fact about the region that my Azure resource groups are in. And it's off working. Let's go. Your resource groups are in the Japan East region. A fun fact about this region is that it includes Tokyo. Wow, look at that. Which is home to the world's busiest pedestrian crossing, the Shibuya crossing. There you go. Now you can combine your Azure resources with fun facts about where they live. This is humanity's finest achievement. I'm blown away.
They only watch the channel for free technical training. Shoot your viewer comments.
We haven't done this for ages. It's time to answer some viewer comments and questions. HBS Business Solutions says, I am Oracle Forms developer for 14 years. God bless you. For SPA and modern apps, should I learn ASP.NET Core or Angular/Node.js? I think you should do ASP.NET Core and TypeScript. Don't focus on Angular or Node.js, whatever, at the moment. Just do a nice .NET backend, learn TypeScript, so you can get started with any single page app, React or Angular. That's where you should get started. Next. Mark Cook, 4866, if that is your real name, says, seems like Microsoft is embracing React instead of MAUI for their own products. Oh. Now Go instead of C#. You can't say stuff like this, Mark, on a .NET channel. How should we react? Should we go elsewhere, Mark? If they don't want to dog food their own stuff, I can't, with a straight face, recommend you do it either. Do React. Next. What is the proper way that LLMs helps you not need to use MAUI? How else are we going to do multi-platform desktop mobile .NET code? I understood Blazor being replaced by properly learning TS React etc. What is he suggesting to replace MAUI with? I'm suggesting you learn how to do it properly. Either use Kotlin for Android or Swift and SwiftUI for iOS and use GitHub Copilot to help you get there. There you go. Look, I've sold a Microsoft product. Or Flutter. Flutter is popular and used by Google. But if you were starting today, I would not learn .NET MAUI if you'd like to be able to feed your children. Next. Why has .NET MAUI... Oh my God. Why has .NET MAUI failed so badly? I never hear anyone speaking about this technology. I don't even need to give an answer to that one. Next. Giggity Gigs says, coming from a front-end developer who like React, why do I need .NET MVC? Giggity Gigs, the answer is, you don't. Next. I was searching for a good .NET course when I found this video. Oh, brilliant. My SEO is working. I know Laravel, but it's not in demand that much. And I'm torn between .NET and Django right now. What is your advice, guys? Well, I don't have particularly much advice, but I will leave it to the replier, who gave a nice answer, which we'll wrap this up with. Do what you enjoy and what fulfills you, and don't worry about demand. Doing things just for money is the reason our world is a giant trash can. Does it make you happy? Then do it. But do it right. Bless. Right, thanks for watching. As always, please leave a like if you liked it. If you didn't like it, press like 3 times, which is a secret YouTube algorithm for dislikes, because I got rid of the dislike button, so like 3 times if you dislike it. If you don't like me yapping, I actually have a newsletter thing, like a blog. It's linked down below in the description and probably in the pinned comment. Then you don't have to hear the sound of my voice. You can just read it and I can be any voice you like in your own mind, delivered to your email inbox every week. Sounds like a deal. Cheers.